No.
Halakha says that a person is obligated to put on tefillin shel yad prior to the tefillin shel rosh. As we know, the pasuk says, "Ukshertam leot al yadecha." Then, "Vehayu l'totavot ben aynecha." First, you have to have "Ukshertam leot." First, you put on the hand. Then, "Vehayu l'totavot." Together, "Vehayu." Then, we together, and the "Totavot ben aynecha" will be on your between your eyes, which is the tefillin shel rosh. So again, even though in reality these are two separate mitzvot, there's a mitzvah of tefillin shel yad. This is a mitzvah of tefillin shel rosh. And if a person only has one, he still puts on that one. If a person only has the yad, he'll put on only the yad. And if a person has only the rosh, he'll put on only the rosh. However, hachamim, when they made a beracha, since both mitzvot, both of these tefillin, are lezikaron, to remember Hashem, so therefore there's one reason, one ta'am for both of them. Kivan that it's one ta'am for both of them. Hachamim, according to us, Sfaradim, ומתקן one beracha for both together. Again, really, in Ikar HaDin, it's two separate mitzvot. You have a mitzvah of tefillin shel yad, you have a mitzvah of tefillin shel rosh. Each one should be separate. However, when Hachamim ומתקן the beracha, according to the Sfaradim, they ומתקן one beracha for both. According to the Ashkenazim, they hold, you make two separate berachot. Each one is a mitzvah on its own, you make a beracha for each one. However, even according to the Sfaradim, that we're saying that it's one beracha for both, but it's one beracha if you don't make any kind of hefsek between the tefillin shel yad and the tefillin shel rosh. But if a person made a hefsek between the tefillin shel yad and the tefillin shel rosh, so then your beracha can be hal on both of them together, since you spoke or you answered amen or whatever it is. So you had some kind of hefsek between the beracha of tefillin shel yad and putting it on and the tefillin shel rosh. In that case, you will be obligated to make a beracha on the tefillin shel rosh. So if a person spoke between the tefillin shel yad and the tefillin shel rosh, even if it was by mistake, halakha is that a person would be obligated to make a beracha. And the reason for that is no more that you know, it's no longer that you could take the beracha and use it for the tefillin shel rosh. Since you spoke, you made a hefsek, it separated the two mitzvot. And now on the second mitzvah, you're obligated to make a new beracha of a mitzvah tefillin.